Now you may think you see a grease-painted reformer sitting before you, but trust me, I'm not here to brighten your dismal day.
31 is perhaps the most Rob Zombie-ass movie Rob Zombie's ever made. If that doesn't make any sense to you, you're probably not familiar with the iconic music/horror icon's work. If you're not familiar with Zombie's work, there's really only two things you need to know. Firstly, he's obsessed with 1970s Americana. Secondly, he makes some brutal-ass movies, usually starring a whole cast of colorful characters. 31, for the most part, is not much different from his previous works, and that's both a blessing and a curse.
Might as well be now.
The film follows a group of five carnival workers who get kidnapped in the night and are held hostage in an abandoned warehouse / devil's playground-like location. It looks like the end of pretty much any 80s action movie. They are forced to partake in a violent and brutal game in which the goal is to simply survive 12 hours against a wave of horrific and psychotic killer clowns. To say the plot is paper-thin would be an understatement, as it merely exists to give an excuse for the violence to occur. And that's fine. The real issue with 31 is that because the story rushes into the action so quickly, it forgets to build any sort of reasoning for us to care about any of the violence taking place. In some ways, 31 is a more focused, stripped-down version of Zombie's debut film, Host of a Thousand Corpses. The difference being we spend far less time with the killers and more time in the middle of the action. The balance is off, however, and because of this we get very little out of what I thought were some solid performances from a cast of familiar zombie film faces. Once again, we are greeted to Zombie's wife, Sherry Moon, who over the years has become a much better actress and gives one of her better performances as a fed-up-with-this-shit warrior-type woman. Malcolm McDowell even shows up in a bizarre role that even after finishing the film, I don't know who he is or what he does. This leads to the second major flaw with 31, which is that it may be a little too simplistic for its own good. I'm all for leaving questions unanswered and not spoon-feeding an audience, but that should never be an excuse for not having a plot. I think it's safe to say that this film doesn't have a plot, other than strange people who we know nothing about must survive 12 hours of hell. We don't know why this incident is taking place, nor do we know who's orchestrating it, or why they chose this group of people, or even why we should care that any of this is happening in the first place. The look of the film, however, is fantastic, really nailing that 1970s vibe that Zombie has become known for. The costumes in which the killers wear are unique enough and menacing, with Richard Brake as Doomhead stealing the entire damn show. His performance and look make me wonder why Hollywood didn't cast this guy as the Joker, as he becomes the number one thing 31 will be remembered for years from now. Compared to his other films, the violence in 31 feels a little more on the cartoonish side than we are accustomed to with the zombie movie. Whereas Devil's Rejects and Halloween delivered a more realistic approach to how graphic the violence was, 31 goes for a more comedic take. There's a pretty solid scene involving a chainsaw that is as brutal as it is ridiculous. With the realism removed, it becomes one of Zombie's tamest movies, next to Lords of Salem, which is something I really wasn't expecting after the whole ordeal with the MPAA. I would go as far as to say that from a technical standpoint, 31 is Zombie's weakest film. His direction seems scatterbrained, lacking the confidence he showed with Rejects and Lords of Salem. It's pretty clear that Zombie is directing films in the wrong era. He was born to be a 1970s filmmaker, and in that way I can relate, as I always thought I should have been alive during the 70s. We share the same love of Americana, of a time gone by that will never exist again, when everything had a layer of grit and crazy devil-worshipping cults were society's biggest fears. I respect Zombie as a person, and as a filmmaker. I often find myself seeing the real films that he's failed to put on the screen in my own head, and the fact that he manages to capture any of it is a feat in itself. Despite whatever his grand vision for 31 was, it's not on the screen. Because what we got on the screen was a rushed, messy version of what I wanted it to be.
In hell, everybody loves popcorn.